Let us get in Professor Balram Singh. Professor Balram Singh, joining us from Dartmouth in the US. Professor, thanks so much. First tell us about the School of Indic Studies, sir. Now, what is it mandated to do? What do you guys do and what does your team do?
Well, Indic Studies is a terminology that was coined in 1939 by Professor Brown of University of Pennsylvania. And it is mentioned in the autobiography of Yogi of Paramahansa Yogananda that Professor Brown said, no study is complete in the United States unless we have a department or center of Indic studies to understand the Indian culture, the tradition, the philosophy, and the practices. So that's how we established a center for Indic studies in the University of Massachusetts in 2000.
Right.
And I was the founding director of that. I took retirement from the university in 2015 and continued with my Indic studies and established this Institute of Advanced Sciences. And in that, I have a School of Indic Studies, which is working to bring out four different areas of India's culture: education, philosophy, art and music, and the overall system of natural way of living.
The course per se. So what have you found in your own, academic career, both as a teacher, sir, looking across countries and the waves of similarities that you found that, make up an Indic civilization that is not restricted to what is modern day India?
Very true. I think it's a very good question also. That's something of great interest to me. And I try to essentialize, I'm by training, I'm a scientist. And I work with Ayurveda and yoga. And I have traveled tremendously all over and had an opportunity to meet with people from all over. And I find that essential things in every aspect of life, in terms of health, in terms of science, in terms of today's economics or political system, and in terms of education, India is nobody who can surpass India. Now I want to just give you as a sense of this, not only today. India today is looked at as an average. The Western world looks at India as an average, and India as a country is very diverse. When you take an average, it amounts nothing. So the stories like Ramayana or that of Gandhi or Swami Vivekananda, when he came in 1893. What they bring is eye-opening to the Westerners. So they have not been exposed to those ideas. So I think the whole concept of encyclopedia of Ramayana will be a major event, in my opinion, especially during the
thing, sir, because you're referring to of course Swami Vivekananda at the World Parliament of Religions. At that point of time, I've read his works, his diaries of his travels there, which are published by the Ramakrishna Mission here in Delhi. In terms of a mind space realization, this shifting of India, looking at from Columbus's mindset of, coming to West Indies and the Red Indians, and actually looking at it at a 4,000-5,000-year-old civilization, because earlier it was restricted to, Mesopotamia, Iraq, Egypt. But looking at India as a civilization, how is it being studied? Yoga we talk about, but beyond that, where is it reached?
Unfortunately, it is not being viewed any more differently than what you just mentioned about the European, and they had looked at everything from that. In part is because we have not done a very good work. When I say we, means all the people that here on the panel, all these cultures who are quite familiar with it. They have not done that. And in part, the reason is because the system that we have adopted of education and the governance and the social behavior and the economics is all westernized, very difficult to break through that. So what I think we are now seeing in the world, especially again, I want to mention about Corona time, people reflecting and what that system would be. So you had asked me what I'm doing personally. I'm very interested. I'm interested in enlightening people about the political system that India had, particularly about the Ram Raj, and not in terms of, like I think Anita ji said, not in terms of religion or anything.
India, sir, and Ram Raj is taken in a very religious you know what's happening in India, sir. As soon as you
I'm coming to that.
What would you like to say to those?
I'm quite familiar with that. That's why I look at it very differently. I look at what Ram did, not what he was and what he may have come from and what other people think of it. What he did was very simple things that, you know, what one thing was, he kept his words. You know, that I challenge anybody who came around and say, well, I'm not going to follow Ram because he kept his word and I wouldn't keep my word. That nobody says. He also did for others. You know, he did parhit saris dharma nahi bhai. He did for others. They, you cannot find anybody great in any tradition. You know, I just named a few of them, like Gandhi, even Jesus, Muhammad Sahab, and any great person who will not come out and say, well, I'm going to do it for all my selfish reason and then I'm a great person. It never, doesn't happen. Third thing, which is very important, is that he had something called Prajatantra. You know, that in which he did not make decisions. He had great people, independent people, general people, who advised him what was the best for the people. And that's what he did. He did not impose anything on anybody except on himself. So, you know, that system, Prajatantra, I have published few papers on it. And I'm trying to define what is known as what America is, being a very new country and very advanced country, and understand democracy, you know, claims democracy coming from their oldest democracy. They need to learn a few lessons from Ram Raj.
Okay, fascinating. I love to read those papers.
For more such videos, subscribe to the NewsX YouTube channel, hit the bell icon.